on in, guys. Hope you're all fitting well. If you're new, don't forget to like and subscribe. As you can see, it's first day of winter today, so work on the farm slackening off a little bit, which is not too bad, I suppose. To cut off on all our maintenance and whatever. A few gates to put in on certain fields where I just think it'd make it a bit more accessible with larger equipment. A bit of a shorter journey as well. Yeah, bouncing all around the road out of harvest. Field 13, I think. Yeah, field 13. Let's make it a little bit more easier. The main purpose of this video today is just to get a bit of a rundown and a bit more understanding on the dairy cow side of things and the beef cow side of things. So I see a lot of people asking questions on Facebook and on a lot of farming forums about the animals. So, you know, milk producing and the young and whatsoever. So I just thought I'd do a little video and try and explain it. So I don't know, maybe you understand it a little bit better. Maybe it's just something for you to watch. I don't know. Well, let's go and blow some straw into these. First of all, so when you're buying your cows to start off. Any animal, in fact, you don't need to buy a male version of said animal, whether that be cow, pig or sheep. You do not need a boar, a bull or a tut. As soon as you buy any female animal, they are automatically artificially inseminated. So if you are buying a tough, a boar or a bull, when you're first starting out it is a little bit of a waste of money really, because you don't need them. He's not going to do anything anyway, because they're already pregnant. So I just thought I'd let you know that is number one. So obviously the cow will give birth at the end of the gestation period. Now the gestation period is the period of time from conception to birth, so it's the period of time that the animal is developing in the womb. So they'll give birth at the end of the gestation period, which is obvious. The gestation period is 9 months. So with the cattle, you can start milking your cows. Your cows won't produce milk in the game, in the dairy, so you won't be having any milk in your parlour for the first 10 months. As soon as you hit the 10 month mark, that is when you will start to see that your cows are producing milk. Let's get this straw blowing over. Come on, mother. Can't kill them. So yeah, after 10 months you'll start to see that you are producing milk. Now the cattle will have to be rested for 2 months during the dry period. This is just before they give birth and then three months after they're giving birth, so your milk production will slow right down. So you still will produce milk, you just won't be producing as much. And you don't need to worry, you aren't doing nought wrong. It's just one of them things. Nature, I suppose you could call it. Draw. Doesn't look like a lot, does it? There's next to fuck all straw down there on the floor, but they produce some serious manure. Now, straw, I recommend you bedding them down, because yes, you're going to get manure off them, and if you don't bed them down, you're going to get manure anyway, in slurry form. But bedding them down on straw does up your milk production. I think it's something like 2 or 3%. It's not a lot, but it makes a difference. If you don't bed them down, you won't produce as much, because I suppose your cows aren't as happy. So yeah, I recommend bedding them down. You get surplus amounts of shit. I mean, look, this gets emptied all the time. Selling it down at BGA, spreading it on land, it's just never ending. You do get a good income off it if you're selling it, but you can't beat a bit of free fertiliser, can you? Right, I'll get this bugger filled up. TMR, again, massively affects your milk production. Silo King Shield line, 1,000 plus 4,535 is the one I use. I don't really use it because it's low on slots. Easy enough to use, easy enough to load. If you want 2 straw. Set that mix in. So you've got 2 straw in there. You then want 3 here. happening with this top of the silage. It's amazing clumps that you can't get all your fucking silage out of them. I'm at TMR. Again, I know quite a lot of you don't know how to do it, but I'm still seeing the questions. So I'm currently got Holston cows here in my parlour, my dairy, whatever you want to call it. Now, lactation. In the early stages of lactation for a Holston cow, that is when you are going to get the most milk per day out of your cow. Now, early stages of lactation for Holsteins is anything under 100 days of milking, I've found. So that means the early lactation stages is when your cows have been milked from day 1 to 100. That is classed as early lactation. That is when you get the most amount of milk per head of cow. Saying that, the late lactation cows will produce a lot less milk, which is obvious, but that's anything over 200, so really it should be your early lactation is from your first day of milking to 200 days. Then anything over 200 days is late lactation, which cows will slowly start slowing down and not producing as much milk. But what I've found is they peak from day 1 to 100, not from day 1 to 200. That's why I've said your early lactation is from day 1 to 100, and anything over, because it's just gradually slowing down. Well, it spikes, it's not really accurate to give you a true reading, to be honest. That's all I can really say on dairy cows. So I hope it's made sense to you that. And if it hasn't, just drop a message and say, Jace, do another video, you knob. Make it a bit more clearer, or ask your questions in comments and I'll answer them. So, this now brings me on to the beef cows, the bullocks. So what I will do is just show you. I've got six bullocks in here that don't need to be in here, they need to be up at the farm, so I'm just going to run them up. So he's go in. I only had three in my little trailer, but it's more pointless to keep wagging out of it there just for six bullocks. This will test a little hard Land Rover out. Sat down up back end. Grab a coffee and then I'll see you up at the farm, guys. Okay guys, so this is first of the three we've just brought with us. They're a lot better off of here. Out it where everyone knows women just do no but drain on anyway, so they'll love it up here with guys, won't they? Right. Let's get this bugger packed up out of it. Where? So, beef. What do we say about the beef cues? So, best time to sell your beef cows. Wait. Your bullocks, your beef, your head of beef, is when they weigh between £1,200 and £1,400. You can obviously, you can sell them when they're heavier, or you can sell them when they're a bit lighter. It's entirely up to you, but how I've found is the best time to sell them is between £1,200 and £1,400 in weight. Just your meat's the leanest then. So yeah, you're getting paid for quality rather than quantity, aren't you? That's what I've found anyway. I'm not saying it's the best way, I'm not saying it's the right way. It's just what I've found works. If you have a look in your animal dialogue and compare weights of your, the weight of your animal at anything between £1,200 in weight and £1,400 in weight, I can guarantee that'll be the best price you'll get. We're going to say we might have to buy some silage bales in, but I've got plenty of other farms and bring some silage down here just in case you run out. A nice little job for winter, bringing a tractor and trailer load down. And that'll do them buggers. Yeah, so selling them between 12 and 14 is best. I will be selling this stock. I'll probably sell it. Everything I've got, 60, what was it? 62. It's just an article load, is that? I'll probably sell everything here. Last day of winter, beginning of spring, and then I'll show you. Me bringing them on to a finishing weight and selling them, and we'll add a few back, and I'll just show you the difference in price between when you sell them at £1,200 and £1,400 in weight, and when you sell them at a bit more, like, just so you have a bit more getting of what I'm saying. Beef cattle, it's entirely up to you, but I don't bed barn down on straw. Number one, you've seen how much shit I have up at dairy farm that I'm sure I struggle to get rid of, like, so I don't bed them down. And number two, I'm on PS4, bloody bale count. Bed back down, we'll pick the other three up and we'll bring them to the new home. And then we'll call that a do. finished. Say, guys, the minis are the best beef cow. They are actually known as the carcass breed, and they do have a natural efficiency in converting feed to meat. So bear that in mind if you want to make money off beef. Limousines at best you can get, and it works out cheaper. You buy them, you're cheaper feeding them. Don't feed them TMR or out like that. I wouldn't even bother with grass out here. All I ever chuck in my mind is silage, and it fills up your grass, your alfalfa windrow, and it fills up your hay as well. Just give them silage. Don't be mixing it up. There's really no need. Right, guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I hope it's been helpful. See you later. Ta-ra.